I'm very, very honored to be presenting New York-based Chicago-born saxophone, baritone sax and flute player, Jonah Parzen-Johnson. Let's give a warm welcome to Jonah.
for a long time, really all the time, I've struggled with the idea that work can be fun. I think that, like, if you're already choosing to be a musician, there's a challenge in convincing yourself and everyone that it's a job. But somehow it feels easier when it's difficult, when there's struggle. And I think it's actually really easy to struggle if you tell yourself you're struggling. To convince yourself that you practice because you have to. That spending hours going to places all over and just exposing yourself to the experience of being far away from home is hard. That you don't love sending emails to people trying to convince them to go to shows. So I told myself all those things were difficult and a struggle. And in a way, it made me feel better about being a musician. But maybe it's okay to like your job. Maybe it's okay to enjoy even the most difficult parts of what you do every day. Because it's part of a larger practice that lights you up. Maybe.
Mm-hmm. giving up. I don't know about you, but I feel like most of my life I've heard people say that over and over again. Just never give up. Just keep going. And I think that people should give up. When I keep doing something because I don't want to give up, I feel like I'm doing it because I should do it. And I think in that never give up world, it's really easy to forget what you want to do. But when you give up, you have a chance to start again. And when you start again, you can know that it's because you really want to. And you can find the love in what you do. Makes you nervous to say that. Because people are like, oh, it's like kind of lazy. But I feel like I gave up every day. really beautiful music that came before and set an incredible standard for me to try to reach in my set. And to Steven and the whole team for hosting. I'm having a blast. And I want to do it again someday with all of you. In a perfect world, I would book a show in Cleveland and all of you would give me your addresses. And about 2 months before the show, I would fly into town, knock on all your doors, and let you know about the show coming up. But it's just not possible. At least not yet. So I need to find another way to keep in touch with you. And so far, the best thing that I've found is email. Unfortunately, I'm not the only one. And all of you are getting a lot of email these days. And I feel like at this point, your email address has become like almost like a precious commodity. Like your social security number or something. You only can give it to people you trust. And you don't know me, so how could you trust me? So over time, I've been working on a small trust exercise, a gesture of goodwill to you, to hopefully build a little bit of that trust ahead of time. So in exchange for considering trusting me with your email address, I'm going to trust all of you with my third most precious possession here tonight, my phone. I have a little note in here called Cleveland Friends. And I would love for you to put your email address in here so that we can keep in touch. Could you put in your email address and then go into my banking app and take away all my money? Maybe. But I don't think you will, because I trust you. If none of this is compelling to you, and you're like, come on, you probably have Face ID lock on your bank anyway. And you don't trust me with your email address, that's okay, but maybe like write your name down instead, because this has been a beautiful night, and someday, decades from now, when I'm wondering if it was all worth it, and I still have the same phone, I can look at the note and remember tonight, and remember that, yes, of course, it was I have a couple 7-inch records for sale. Unfortunately, I sold everything else that I was traveling with on tour, but if you're interested in any recordings, I'll happily ship it to you for free, since it's my fault I don't have any with me, and we can talk about that in the back. The last piece I'm going to play is called There's So Much to Look Forward To. My name is Jonah Parzen-Johnson. I'm really grateful to get to play for y'all tonight, and I hope to see you again sometime soon.
Mm-hmm.